Hello, sir.
How are you, buddy?
Fine, sir. After all, good evening to you all.
Very good
Everyone
evening.
is
How are you?
getting tired.
Very good evening.
Now you
First
want
of
to
all,
start about the.
am
First
I
of all,
audible?
yourself. Yeah, fine. You are audible now.
Okay, good.
Yes, sir. You can start about your introducing, then we will work on the letter.
Okay, hi, folks. I am Captain Vishal Gupta. I'm based out of Mumbai. Currently, I'm flying for a very good airline. About me, my total experience in terms of years is around 14 years currently. In terms of hours, about 9,000 hours on Airbus A320. I started my journey back in 2006 dreaming of becoming a pilot. And it's been a beautiful, beautiful journey so far. Educational qualification wise, I'm an MBA, and then I started my aviation journey. I was working as a chef in Amby Valley. So it's still interesting to know how people diversify their careers and, reach which you have never imagined of. So I'm working as a chef in Amby Valley city, which is close to Lonavala, Pune. One of my friends and colleagues in my MBA course mate was a pilot, and he was jobless for about, 4 years. To earn his bread and butter, he was working in Amby Valley city as a airport controller and taking care of his living. So then suddenly aviation boomed in India in 2006, and he got an internal transfer to Air Sahara. So it was always nice. It was always very nice to, listen to his stories about flying. And, for a layman, it was very fascinating.
Right.
So while he was going to Air Sahara as a pilot, as a first officer, he asked me a question. He said, "Vishal, I see you as a very bright kid with a lot of ambitions, with big hopes in life. Why don't you become a pilot?" And like many students, I asked them, "Oh, can I become a pilot?" I thought, pilots are God-sent people and they are, angels of God. I never thought that, I can become a pilot. So my counter question to him was, what do I need to be to become a pilot? So then he asked me, eligibility wise, you need to be 12th pass. You need to be having science background, physics and maths are mandatory. So fortunately, I had that. And then third element was, how much money do I need to spend for this training?
The money is the main thing, actually. Many people ask about it. How much was the money costing? Right.
Correct. So at that time, fuel prices were very low. Aviation demand was very low. So the estimate he had given me was about 12 lakh rupees to do a CPL single engine training.
Only 12 lakh rupees, right?
Only 12 lakh rupees. Which
at that time, it was costly at that time.
Yeah. No, in 2006, he told me an estimate of 12 lakh rupees to do flying in India.
In 2006,
Yeah, which again was a huge amount considering my family background. So I come from a very humble background.
Right.
So I said, look, it's a lot of money. I have to take, permission from my father if he can help me with this funding. So I spoke to my parents, and then my parents took the, 2 weeks of time to, do their, budgeting and all. So finally, my parents gave me a thumbs up to start the training. And I completed my MBA, resigned from Sahara, and started my aviation journey, packed my bags, came to Delhi. Now, this was the phase where a lot of, aviation boom came in. Kingfisher started, Indigo started, and suddenly, suddenly there is, a lot of demand for pilots, fuel prices shot up. So the training estimate cost, which was given around 12 lakh rupees, shot up to straight away 20, 25 lakhs to do CPL.
Right. I said, in 2006, it will cost.
Yeah,
cost 25 lakh approx total, right?
No, actually more. So the price is shot up to that.
Okay,
so
shot
then,
up to that.
Yeah, so then I went to Jaipur to start my flying. My first air experience was in Jaipur. I spent 2 months to do only one sortie there. Then I switched my flying school to AAA, Ahmedabad Aviation Academy. There for 4 months, only to do about 9 hours. And luckily, I've always been a good student. I have done well in my academics throughout. So during this 6 months, I passed all my papers. NAV, MAT, REX, technical, both, Indian RT.
Everything, 6 months, right?
Everything was done in 6 months. And then flying wise, I have just done about 10 hours. I thought, you know, okay, I'll become old in becoming pilot in India and I will not get a job. So finally, I spoke to my parents again. My uncle, who was a vice chancellor in one of the very reputed universities of Delhi, Indraprastha University.
Okay.
So, yeah, he was the founder vice chancellor. So for all the guidance, career-wise, education-wise, we see to him.
Okay.
So then we approached him. I said, look, Mamu and my father were sitting. I said, I need to go to, you know, some foreign country to start my flying, to expedite my flying. Otherwise, it's taking too long.
Okay.
So they did a bit of research and they said, okay, fine, good. But now the school I chose was Dean International Miami, which okay. was also had a tie up with Pan Am, if you have heard about it.
Okay.
Yeah. So that was a very good school back then in 2007, one of the best in the US. Slightly okay. expensive. Slightly expensive. It. I'm sorry, guys. The calls okay. just don't stop coming and then some network crashed.
Okay. Okay.
All right. So,
I thought it's my network crash.
No, I don't know whose, but yeah, I just couldn't join in the back. The calls okay, just don't stop coming, man.
Okay.
Sorry, guys, for the interruption. Accept my apologies. So where were we? Yeah. So we are on our way to Miami. So finally, I decided to, you know, enroll into Dean International Miami. Unfortunately, that school is shut now due to a couple of crashes that happened due to the owner of the school was diagnosed with some cancer problems. So they just could not, you know, could not survive the pressure probably. But back then, it was one of the best schools. So I went there with a very clear vision. That aim was to get a job. Going back one step, so now this entire CPL, which was planned at 12 lakh rupees to begin with, the total costing, because I spent some money in India, I spent some money, you know, gave some money to Ahmedabad Aviation Academy, gave some money to Jaipur. So there was a bit of money wasted. So in total, basically, it costed me around 40 lakh rupees back then also.
Okay.
Okay. So of course, for my CPL flight training in US, I took a loan from a bank. Okay. My parents had the budget of 10, 12 lakh rupees, but now we are talking about 40 lakh rupees.
40 lakhs, right.
Yeah. So I went there with a very clear vision that I will be very focused, complete my flying as soon as I can and come back to India and look for a job.
Okay.
So it started at a very normal pace. Since I had studied very well, so my approach to study is I will share and I would highly recommend a lot of people read or learn to pass. But I have always read or learned to understand the things. Once you understand the things, passing is just a formality.
Yeah, right.
So when I did my
everything, if you are reading a lot, like reading the everything's perfectly, you have to be
correct. So once your concepts are cleared, it's easy to, you know, crack any interview, any written paper. So I went to States, started my ground school. So eventually in a month's time, there was a buzz which was created. Okay, there's a guy called Vishal Gupta. He's quite brilliant and he's very good with his books, very good with the theory.
Okay.
So Robert Dean, who was the owner of the school, one fine day, he called me to his office. He said, Mr. Gupta, we are hearing some very nice things about you. You know, how come you're a little different? I said, sir, I have just done my ground classes in India and I studied, you know, with a good intention to understand the concept. Probably that is coming a big help in US. He said, okay, fine. I have a proposal for you. I said, what is it? He said, if I give you an exemption to attend any ground school in US, are you comfortable passing your written exams and your VIVAs with FA on your own? I said, look, I have never thought about it, but if you ask me, I think I can. I will require a bit of guidance from you guys, but theory-wise, I am okay.
Maybe I just put my pots back. Maybe some.
No problem.
We are nice
no problem.
Now. We are in the working experience. It approx 14.5 years, right?
Yeah, so around 13 years of commercial aviation flying and about, you know, 6-8 months otherwise doing some general aviation flying. Over this period of 13 years, I've accumulated about 9,000 hours on Airbus 320. And I'm a trainer on Airbus 320.
Yeah, that's right.
I train all the airline pilots. Not all, but whatever is allocated to me.
Okay.
Yeah.
Then, approximately, you are able to train, from when you started for training pilots?
So, when I joined Indigo in 2010, December, I was promoted to a captain early 2000.
Okay.
So, after 2 years, so 2013, I became a trainer. And it's been about 8 years of training pilots now.
Okay. Now we're going to discuss the hierarchy of pilots, right? Just you can elaborate it, the hierarchy.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, sure. So, I'll talk about the career progression, which, happens in the airline, and they're maintaining the standards which they're supposed to. So, this is the career progression from junior first officer to examiner. How fast you can reach, it depends on your personal interest towards training, personal performances, your knowledge, your skill. Most importantly, your attitude. You cannot become a good trainer if you don't have a good attitude. I mean, I can be extremely skillful, but if I don't have the, passion to teach, to train, then it's really not worth it, I would say. So these are the few elements which are required to become a good trainer. And this is the career progression for an airline pilot. Back again.
DC, I can restart, right?
Yeah. Yeah.
Okay. I thought I got the very network issue right now.
I have no idea what is happening, why it is getting disconnected, but I just stopped hearing you totally.
Right. Okay. Just we are talking about the hierarchies now, okay? Just elaborate, just brief explain about the hierarchy because I haven't heard anything in the live.
So, in terms of career progression of a pilot, you start as a junior first officer. Okay. Once you gain certain hours, get your ATPL license, which takes about maybe a year and a half, 2 years. You are promoted to a senior first officer. Then from your senior first officer, your next progression is becoming a commander, a captain, on whatever type of aircraft you're flying. Then after flying about 2 years, your next promotion is to start training other pilots. The first rank as a trainer is called LTC, Line Training Captain in India.
Okay, LTC.
Okay. Right. Different countries have different names for this rank. Few countries, they don't have this rank at all. But in India, first rank towards becoming an airline trainer is LTC.
Okay.
LTC. Okay. Then, so LTC, what it does is it gives training to new pilots on the aircraft.
Okay.
Okay. Then your next rank is, which again takes about two and a half years after LTC, is your TRI. It's called Type Rated Instructor.
Type Rated, okay.
Yeah. So what is the difference between LTC and TRIs? TRI basically starts giving training in a simulator and in aircraft both.
Okay.
Simulator training is a very key element towards airline training. So about 80-90% of the training which pilot undergoes happens in a simulator device. Interruptions, I'm sorry. Right. I don't know the reason behind it. But maybe in case we disconnect again, we'll plan this live session again soon with a better network. Maybe it's a bandwidth. Right. So we'll find it out. So yeah, so we were talking about career progression. I hope I was audible till about LTC. After line training captain, next step is TRI, type rated instructor. The difference between a line training captain and a type rated instructor is a TRI gives training, imparts training on a simulator device and aircraft both, whereas line training captain only trains on an aircraft. Okay. Now, most of the training, about 80% of the training which a pilot undergoes happens in a simulator. So TRI is a very, very key role in the airline.
Okay.
So next, the final promotion is becoming an examiner where you start start conducting checks on behalf of DGCA for the airline pilots if they are proficient and they're maintaining the standards which are required by the regulator. So this is your career progression. Takes about 8-10 years. 10 years is a very, very become examiner. So you have to do everything right. Knowledge, skill, attitude, no hierarchy, career progression.
Right, right. Career progression are done. Now we're going to talk about the salary and then the eligibility, normal eligibility criteria, then the best flying schools in India.
So, salaries though, I think for the aspiring pilots, money should be secondary. chasing your passion, love for flying should come first. But all I can say is, if you become an airline pilot, you're paid well enough, life is good, you have, you know, airline takes good care of the employees, of the pilots. Beginning salary starts from around 1.8, 1.7. That was pre-COVID. I don't know what will be the post-COVID standards. And then as you grow, money also keeps growing. If I have to say something, focus on the, you know, quality of work you can deliver. Focus on your self-development. And money is a byproduct of your success. There's enough money in the market.
Then we gonna talk about the best flying schools in India right now. The best flying schools, according to you.
Well, to be very honest, flying schools in India, I will not be very, very sure when I'm saying this. But amongst the better ones, reputed ones in India, a few of them are IGRUA, Chimes Aviation.
Right.
IndiGo has just made a tie-up for a cadet pilot, I think, with Chimes. So IGRUA and Chimes, I think there was NFTI in Gondia, which was quite good. But in general, if you ask me, our Indian government is promoting flying in India big time. But in general, I think we are still behind by a big margin in terms of general aviation exposure compared to states or few other countries. But things are getting better. I hope, you know, our general aviation infrastructure improves adequately going forward in future.
Right. According to you, the best institute in Mumbai, in nearby to Mumbai, because many people are from my live session or my followers, many people are from Mumbai. They wanted to nearby to Pune. What are the best institutes in Mumbai, according to you?
As far as I know, there are a lot of academies in and around Mumbai, a lot of academies in New Delhi. To be very honest, again, academies are something which I don't deal with. But I can tell you with a lot of surety, a couple of my very, very close friends who are airline pilots, I think they have opened up a state-of-the-art academy named Airbus in Mumbai. So I had a chat with my friend. So what I was told was... So basically, they want to provide fair, accurate, reliable, and affordable guidance to, you know, all the budding pilots. Basically, they have everything in their academy. If you are a 12th pass student and you aspire to be a pilot and also, I think, cabin crew, you can consult them. They will provide you guidance from their first step all the way till you become an airline pilot. This is the kind of setup they've got. I have not been there as so far because I've been so busy traveling. But... I believe it's quite good. Quite good. Quite nice. Very classy.
Let's you share me the link of that academy I will share to the students.
I will do that. I think their Instagram page is Airbus Training. AIRBUZZ.
Okay. Put a link in my next story.
I will do that.
It's been an interrupting session, but we will clear. We cleared everything, you know, about your experience, about the hierarchy, about the salary, but we cleared everything. It's been a good talking to you. It's a good conversation with you. It's my the first live session. It's also your first live session, right?
First live session, man.
Due to first session. But I will put us all the videos in the same thing. Then I will upload to help all the people.
Okay, fine.
We're gonna meet soon. We don't. I used to come Mumbai. You are based at Delhi. I will meet there.
Sure.
Okay, sir. Thank you so much for everything, for being humble to us. It's been a good talking to you.
Pleasure is totally mine. Thanks for having me over and wish you all a happy landing, safe skies and keep smiling, keep dreaming. God bless you all. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Thank you.